So this is the next easiest method to perform the three-digit multiplication number. Okay, so this is what I have come with the number means 198 into 256. This is 198 into 256. So this is a three-digit multiplication number. So when you perform our childhood method like 195 into 256, it will go on step. Then we need a finger to leave. Then we need a leg for no. We need a legs to keep the remaining. So we need a lot of fingers. The 10 fingers doesn't support us to perform these kind of problems. Okay, so for those such people to feel a very tough to handle these kind of a problem, this stepwise method will be going to help you immensely. Okay, so let's see the step by step process. Okay, so this is also the basic what I have taught you before, that is for the two digit, that is. So this is also the same method. So we have for a three digit, we want to add a little bit, one more step, no, as a additionally. Okay, so 198 into 256. So I have written step one, I have written it like this, 198 into 256. Okay, so we want to perform the multiplication for the last one digit. Okay, for the two digit number also, we want to perform the first step. What is the first procedure for first step? We want to perform the multiplication for the last two digit number. Same thing for the 2, 3 or 4 digit. We want to perform the first last digit number multiplication. So 8 into 6 is equal to 48. So same thing. So 8 should be written to the final answer and the 4 should be added to the next. So 4 should be carried to the next step. So what is the next step? So 198 into 256. So we want to do the perform the cross multiplication for the last two digit number. So 99 into 6 and 5 into 8. So 9 into 6 plus 5 into 8. So 9 into 6, 94 plus 4. That is after adding the 96 plus 5 in 94. We have got the 94 as the answer. So 94 plus 4 is equal to 98. Okay, so 98. So same thing. The 8 should be added to the final answer and the 9 should be carry to the another step. So next, what is the another step? We want to do the cross multiplication for the each and every given number. So 198 into 256. So we want to perform the multiplication to the each and every number. For example, 1 into 6, 8 into 2 and 9 into 5. So we want to perform the cross multiplication and want to cover the every single digit. So 1 into 6, 2 into 8, 9 into 5 plus 9. So 9 is the previous carrying answer. So then the final answer will be the 76. So same thing, we want to return the 6 here and 7 should be carried to the another next step. Okay, so again 198 into 256. So here we want to perform the cross multiplication for the first two digit number. In the second step, we have performed the cross multiplication for the last two digit. Okay, from the last two digit. So in the fourth method, we want to perform the multiplication for the first two digit. So whereas 1 into 5 and 2 into 9. So this 5 will be the carry, or sorry, this 7 will be the carry for the carry from the previous step. And then the final answer will be the 30. So 30 have written a 0 here and the 3 will be the carry to the next step. So next step is 198 into 256. So we want to perform the multiplication for the first two row, first two digit. Okay, so first two digit means here, the first digit. So 1 into 2. So 1 into 2 is equal to 2. So we want to take a carry from the previous step as from the 3. So 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. So we have written a 5 to the final answer. So the final answer for the 198 into 256 will be the 50,688 is the final answer. Okay, so don't worry, I'm going to tell one more time. If somebody will doesn't understand for one time, basically we need a explanation more when it comes to the mathematics, is especially it needs a special attention. Okay, somebody will doesn't understand 4th and 5, no problem, I will come again one more time, please listen carefully. So this is a 3-digit multiplication. So this is a trick to multiply the 3-digit number. Okay, so 198 into 256. So first step, 198 into 256. Okay, so 8 into 6 is equal to 48. So we want to perform the first digit. 8 into 6 is equal to 48. So we want to return the last digit to the final answer here. The 4 should be carried to the another step. So what is the second step? 198 into 256. So where is, like, same thing. So cross, we want to perform the cross multiplication. So 9 into 6 plus 5 into 8. So 9 into 6 plus 5 into 8. So totally 94. So this 4 will be the carry from the previous step. So 94 into 4 is equal to 98. So here the last digit should be added to the final answer, and 9 will be remaining same here. Okay, next, third step. 198 into 256. So in this third step, so for your better remaining, so or you to feel it's comfortable, you may feel, oh, what is the steps, a large step, we can perform our old method. You may think when it comes as a step, for your better understanding, it's I'm keeping a step, but when once you understand the step, once you remind the step, it will be easy. So for your remaining step, to remember the step, I can tell you easy method. So you will do it, definitely you will do it the first step. So for everything, for the 2-digit multiplication, or even it's 3, or even it's 4, no problem, you can perform the last 1-digit to the multiplication. You will do it the first step. And the second step, if it is a 2-digit or a 3-digit, you want to multiply the last 2-digit for the second step. Okay, so where is the fourth step? Also the similar, but we want to perform the first 2-digit. Okay, so this is that to remember. So the center one for this and this, for the center one from for the 2 and 4, third step will be the center. So center step, we want to multiply the each and every number. So we want to perform the cross multiplication to the each and every number. 1 into 6 and 2 into 8 and 9 into 5. That is, the each and every number should be get multiplied. Okay. So 1 into 6 plus 2 into 8 plus 9 into 5 plus the 9 will be the carry from the previous step. So 94, then the answer will be the 76. So as usual, the last digit should be added to the final answer and 7 should be remaining. So the 7 should be carried to the next step. So next, fourth step, 198 into 256. So 1 into 5 and 9 into 2 is equal to 5 plus 18. So next, this 7 is we get from the previous number. Okay, so that is a 30. So final answer will be the 30. So 0 is added to the final answer and the 3 will be carried to the next step. Okay, so next step, 198 into 256. So we want to perform the first 2-digit. So the first, always when it is a 2-digit or 3-digit or 4-digit, always 1 and the last step. So when it comes as a 4-digit, it will take 6 to 7 steps. But no, don't care about the step. Just remember the first and last position. When it comes as a 2-digit or even when it comes as a 3-digit, don't worry. We want to listen about the, we want to remember about the first step and the last step will be same. So in the first step, you are going to perform the last first digit number. In the last step, you are going to perform the first 1-digit number. So same. In every method, the second step and the from the last to previous method will be the same. Okay, the next step to the first one and the previous to the last step will be the same. Only the center will be the different from the every step. Not very different. We want to do the multiplication. We want to perform the multiplication for the each and every number. So this is the same thing. Okay, so here the final answer will be the 5 and the 5 is added to the final answer. So 198 into 256. For this, the final answer will be the 50,688. So this is another example sum to perform the 3-digit multiplication number. So okay, So here I have taken 234 into 482. So first step. So always I have said the first step and the last step should be the same. And the first next step, that is the second step, and the previous to the last step will be the same. Okay. So what is the first step? 234 into 482, isn't it? So we want to take it only the first one digit, that is a 4 into 2 is equal to 8. So I have taken the to the final answer 8. So next step, we want to perform the cross multiplication for the last two digit number. So this is the last two digit number. So 3 into 2 and 4 into 8. So finally we get 38 as the answer. So I have taken a 8 here and the 3 will be carried to the next step. So next step, we should do the cross multiplication for the each and every number. So like a 234 into 482. Okay, so this is we want to perform the cross multiplication to the each and every number, like 2 into 2, 4 into 4, and 3 into 8. So this 3 will be the we got the carry from the previous number. So finally we get the answer 47. So we have taken the 7 to the here and the 4 will be the carry to the another digit number. Next step, that is. Okay. So and what is the next step? 234 into 482. So what I have told you, the always second step and the last previous from the last step will be the same, isn't it? The first and last will be the same, and the second and the previous from the last step will be the same. Why I didn't mention, why I'm not mentioning fourth step, third step, means because when it comes as a four digit number multiplication, it will take nearly a six step or seven step. So when I tell the fourth step, you may get confused because in the four digit number, the fourth step will be a different. So I'm not mentioning the step number, I'm mentioning the position. So they are always the second step position and the last from the previous position will be the same. Not same means step same. Here we are going to perform the cross multiplication for the last two digit number. Here we are going to perform the multiplication for the first two digit number. Okay, so this and the for the first one also like the same one. The first and last will be the same method. We are going to perform the multiplication for the last one digit, and here also we are going to perform the multiplication for the first one digit. Okay, so here fourth step, we are going to perform the multiplication, isn't it? So 2 into 8 plus 4 into 3, so 16 plus 12, this 4 will be the, we getting the carry from the previous step 4, then the final answer will be the 32. So as well as we are going to return the 2 here, the 3 going to be carry over from the to the next step. Okay, so the last step, 234 into 482. So here we want to perform the first two digit multiplication, 2 into 4, so 8 plus 3, where I got the 3, I got the 3 from the previous number, isn't it? 8 plus 3 is equal to 11. So I have taken 11 here, so then the final answer will be 234 into 408. The final answer will be 1,12,788 will be the final answer. Okay, so don't forget the step. Okay, to remember very easily, I have told you about the some tricks. When it comes as a two digit number, like a 62 into 71, also when it comes as a three digit number, 232 into 700, anything, when you are following this method, always first step and the last step will be the same, only the position will be changed. Okay, first step and the last step will be the same, and always the second step and the previous from the last step will be the same, only the center point will be the differ from, not differ also, it will going to be multiply the each and every number. That is, we are going to multiply the cross, we are going to perform the cross multiplication for the each and every number. That is going to be a different for the each and every one. Okay, so this is a basic tricks to remember the steps. Okay, so you may feel like you may be felt like, so why Remembering these kind of steps will be a very difficult. So why can't I do it my regular method? The remembering of the step is not so difficult. So that's what I'm saying. If you keep everything is very easily, then anything is going to be very easy for you. So always the first and the last will be the same procedure. Only the positioning of a number will be the different. And always the second method and the last from the previous will be the same. Only the center method will be going to be differ from the each and everything. Okay, so this is the basic mathematical tricks to perform the 3-digit multiplication.